serotonin, norepinephrine, reuptake inhibitors. These medications, in theory, reuptake not only serotonin, but norepinephrine. Norepinephrine is an excitatory neurochemical that is closely associated with dopamine. Dopamine and norepinephrine are more aligned with what one thinks of mood elevation and antidepressants. Norepinephrine flows into the synapse and increases the intensity of a nerve impulse. It is then reuptaken naturally to be used again. Norepinephrine is associated with memory and the ability to focus on a task. Low epinephrine could result in a lethargic depression, an inability to find reward in life, attention problems, and a difficult time focusing on such tasks like reading and comprehension. Excessive norepinephrine most often presents as anxiety. We will discuss more about norepinephrine when we talk about dopamine. SNRIs then are meant to increase the availability of serotonin and norepinephrine. And so theoretically, they would lower someone's impulsivity and help stimulate them out of depression. That actually sounds kind of wonderful. Unfortunately, this intended effect, again, for reasons mentioned earlier, may not be sustainable. Also, for someone that is anxious, an SNRI can markedly increase that anxiety. Antidepressants have varying half-lives, with Effexor being the shortest at less than 1 day, and Prozac at the longest at possibly 5 or more days. The height of withdrawal tends to hit right after the half-life. Antidepressants with a shorter half-life generally are more problematic if someone were to cold turkey, as they may leave the system faster than the person can adjust. On the average, a person can expect withdrawal manifestations from an antidepressant to occur 24 hours to 5 days after the taper, and in general, days 2 to 3. Once someone surmounts their first taper, whatever pattern of symptoms they had, and the timing and onset of those symptoms, and then relief, will be similar to what they can expect on each taper. This withdrawal pattern is consistent for all medications, with the special exception being antipsychotics, which we will explain in detail later.